Good morning, church. It is great to be with you again this morning. If you're not in the Kirksville area, it is 5 degrees here, and there's snow on the ground that's been there all of this year. So that's a little encouraging words for those of you in South Texas, that you made the right choice to not be here. Do you know, one of the things that I've struggled with throughout this pandemic and the precautions we needed to take around that is the is the inability or maybe the unwise nature of traveling. And as much as I like to travel, I like to go places and I like to experience things and see new people and new places and do things like that. And that's something that I'm longing for. I'm longing for that opportunity to get back on the road and do things and to be different places. And when I thought about trips that I've enjoyed in the past, of course, I enjoy, hopefully, nearly every year we get a trip to Colorado. We do some hiking out there and enjoy that a lot. And our middle son just moved to Florida, and especially on a 5-degree day, I'm looking forward to going to Florida. But one of the trips that I remind myself of often, and because it was such a monumental opportunity to see things, was a trip to Italy we took several years ago. And one of the days while we were there, we made the reservation to take a tour of the Vatican. And the Vatican is different than I expected. It's much bigger than I expected, and it's much more beautiful than I could have imagined. And as we took the tour through the Vatican, one of the stops through the tour is in the Sistine Chapel. And the Sistine Chapel is famous for the painting on the ceiling. Of course, the whole chapel is beautiful, but particularly people go in and they have their heads bent towards the ceiling the whole time, looking at the different paintings that were there by mostly Michelangelo and a few of the artists that worked for him. But the picture from the Sistine Chapel that people remember the most is this image of God as some sort of a grandfatherly-like character with his hand outstretched, and a person, a man that's indicating that if, Adam are all human beings, reaching back towards God and their fingers just about touching. And it's a beautiful painting. Theologically, I have a lot of issues with it, but it's one of those things, it's one of those images that sticks with you. But the reason I have challenges with it is this idea that God is somewhere distant, that God is somewhere outside of our reach, that God is like an elderly man that's sitting up in some distant heaven that is we're reaching out to try and grasp. And I don't find that fits well with my understanding of God, because I believe that God is with us everywhere we go. No matter what we do, what we say, no matter where we go throughout the entire world, you cannot escape God. In fact, there's many scriptures that remind us of that, that God is everywhere we go. And God is in our hearts in the form of the Holy Spirit. And that God is as close to us as our breath, that there's no distance, there's no gap between the finger of God and ours. And I think that the reason that that type of understanding of God works so much better for me is because I don't feel like that God is up there manipulating the levers and strings of the world, trying to make sure everything works out in a certain way. Because God is there in our hearts. And we have a lot of the control over what happens. We have free will to make the right choices, or we have the free will to make the wrong choices. But there's so many things in our life that that God is there with us, and God walks the paths with us, God grieves with us, God laughs with us. God is a personal God, our Creator. And I found a couple of verses I'd like to share with you that help remind us that God is always there. Joshua 1:9 says, "Have I not commanded you to be strong and courageous? Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go." Or even if you're stuck at home because of the pandemic, God is there. In Isaiah 41, we read verse 10, "Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be afraid, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my victorious right hand." So many different scriptures throughout the entire Bible reminds us of God's eternal presence with us wherever we go. And one of the benefits I've seen, and this is hard to find benefits maybe from our isolation and restriction, but one of the benefits I've seen is that we've expanded this idea of what it means to worship, that you can worship wherever you are, and you can worship at home. and watching and participating with the worship online. It gives us an opportunity to look at worship in so many different ways. You don't have to be in the Sistine Chapel or somewhere like that in order to really experience God, because God is all places. And I'd like to give you one more verse. This comes from Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 8, starting with verse 38. For I'm convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. And I think that's very important for us to hang on to, because I feel like that it's easy to think that something is standing in the way between us and God, that something has separated us from God. And nothing can be further from the truth, because God is Spirit, and God's Spirit is with us wherever we go, and God's Spirit is there to comfort and guide us. God's Spirit is there to nudge us in the right direction. God's Spirit is there to give us peace. Well, the song I'd like to share with you this morning is one that was written by a contemporary Christian artist named Tim Timmons. Excuse me. Even in the wintertime, allergies kick up, as you know. But this song's written by Tim Timmons, and it is titled Everywhere I Go. And what it's talking about is that no matter where you are, that God is there. And God is there to guide us and to strengthen us. Now, normally I do this song with a band. And so I'm thinking in my background, I'm hearing a bass guitar, and I'm hearing drums, and I'm hearing these other things going on. So if I look a little zoned out, it's because I'm thinking about the rest of this band. And you know what you could do? You could help me by clapping along. Why don't you do that? Why don't you clap along and sing, if you know any of the words to this, or just you'll pick up the chorus, I think, pretty fast. Everywhere I go. There's a city that calls me by name. There's a city that calls me by name. Yes, and I run this race, I am cheered by the saints. There's a city that calls me by name. Everywhere I go on this road, high and low, where I go with you. So I won't be afraid, it's my home, come what may. Where I go with you. Where I go with you. There's a future that runs through my veins. There's a future that runs through my veins. And there's nothing on earth that could stand in the way. There's a future that runs through my veins. Everywhere I go on this road, high and low, where I go with you. So I won't be afraid, it's my home, come what may. Where I go with you. Where I go with you. There's a spirit that cannot contain. There's a spirit I cannot contain. The same power that raised Jesus up from the grave. The same spirit I cannot contain. Everywhere I go on this road, high and low, where I go with you. So I won't be afraid, it's my home, come what may. Where I go with you. Where I go with you. Your breath upon these bones, your fire in my soul, your kingdom is my home. I won't walk alone. Your breath upon these bones, your fire in my soul, your kingdom is my home. And I don't walk alone. Everywhere I go on this road, high and low, where I go with you. So I won't be afraid, this my home, come what may. Where I go with you. Everywhere I go on this road, high and low, where I go with you. So I won't be afraid, this my home, come what may. Where I go with you. Where I go with you. Well, I pray that you keep that thought in your mind, that wherever you go, God goes with you. Everywhere you go, no matter where it is, and sometime in the not too distant future, we're going to get to go somewhere. We're going to find a place that we want to go, and we're going to experience God there as well as here. Go in peace and have a beautiful day.